And look, there's six words, which are perhaps the most profound words I've ever heard. And it goes back four decades ago, really. And that is...
Jim, the first time we met, I can remember, this was a while ago, maybe 12, 13, 14 years ago. We were in your office and you pulled out a picture and you asked if I knew who it was. It was you and somebody else. And you showed me the picture and I said, of course, it was you and Bob Proctor. So at that moment, I knew that that mindset was very important to you in business. I want you to talk about that. Mindset, not only in business, but in any... you know, facet of life. How important is mindset to you?
It's extremely important. And thanks for asking me to come on today, Jeremy. Oh,
pleasure is all mine, my friend.
Have a little chat. It's always good to see you and your smiling face and your enthusiasm and positive, contagious energy.
And all likewise, that you do.
Thank
friend.
You. Look, yes, Bob Proctor, mindset is everything. I don't really care what profession you're in. In our industry, commission sales, it's extremely important. And look, there's six words, which are perhaps the most profound words I've ever heard. And it goes back four decades ago, really. And that is, you become what you think about.
So true.
It is. Yeah. It is so true. Yeah. And if you're harboring amazing thoughts and encouraging growth personally and in your own business life, you'll surround yourself by the law of attraction with other people, like-minded individuals. So it's extremely important to have a very positive and growth mindset in your personal life and, of course, in your business life, in my case. And I think that's important in any profession, really. You know, we love being around positive people. You have been in many of folk that have very positive energy. And when you lead those people, you get this feeling of, wow, I really enjoyed that meeting with Jeremy. I'd love to meet him again. I cannot wait to meet him again. So positive mindset, absolutely. And you have to be working on that all the time. It's not something that you're given. Rather, it's something that you earn and that you feel good about. You know, being able to go out and have these thoughts of accomplishing wonderful things. And it's all about doing the little things that add up to the big thing.
It takes practice. And I mean, you look at it, you know, the average person has, as you know, the average person has thousands and thousands of thoughts every single day. And for so many people, a lot of those thoughts are not so good thoughts. They're dwelling on the past, you know, on bad things that happened in the past, or they're fearing what could potentially happen in the future. And a lot of people don't realize the effect that that not only has on us physically and mentally, but what we're attracting to. But in my opinion, what not only what we're attracting, but what we're attracted to on a daily basis, what gets our attention. And I know, you know, a lot of people use the example, what happens when you buy a new car? You start to see that car everywhere. It's not that you start to see it, you start to notice it more because you saw that car the week before and the week before that. But when you buy it, it's relevant. And when it's relevant, your eyes start to pay attention to what's relevant to you. So like you said, I mean, the more positive thoughts we have, the more we're going to be attracted to that positivity. And then, of course, when we act upon it, good things happen.
Yeah. Look, it's you have a garden. You have to weed that garden. We look after our physical health. We do some exercise, we watch what we eat. Your mental health is no different. You have to be extremely careful of your thought process. I say to people, what's the most expensive piece of real estate in the world? And they look at me and they go, well, Hong Kong, or perhaps it's Manhattan, or maybe it's in Toronto. And of course, real estate values in Canada have been escalating. I said, No. The most expensive piece of real estate is the 6 inches between your left ear and your right ear. that is where you harbor these wonderful thoughts about, you know, being able to do the things that you believe that you can do. The me I see is the me I'll be.